Succession is the very important process by which open habitats become mature communities. So you can imagine some bare ground, and then the annual plants will arrive, and then the perennial herbaceous species will arrive, and then the early trees such as birch, and then eventually the later members of the community such as hornbeam and beech will arrive. So you'll move from bare ground to a mature climax community. And there are two main theories of succession. So Clements suggested the process I've just described, that regular process. Gleason suggested that chance was an important component of this. So the way I remember is Clements is certain and Gleason is a gamble. So I'm here with Charlie Burrell at Knepp, site that he's established. Tell us what we're seeing here, Charlie.
Well, this field, Bill, came out of arable in 2004, 2003, I guess that sort of time. It would have been winter wheat. You can see this strip of sallow here is where the set-aside was. So it's a real marked change from set-aside to where the ground was actually worked.
So the small initial differences resulted in completely different communities. And you've got other examples, haven't you?
Yeah, we've got 100 acres of maize that was grown in 2000, and that would have had an atrazine, a chemical spray, a pre-emergent spray. And we think that may have had a real effect on woody shrubby plants coming and colonising that ground. So that looks very different from, say, a field next door, which didn't have maize and came up maybe 4 or 5 years later and has then gone into quite a complex community of woody shrubby plants.
So perhaps rather than a Knepp story, there's a whole family of Knepp stories depending on the starting conditions.
It's really interesting, the randomness of, I think, the beginning of the change. So you go from one state to another, and that randomness of what's actually happening, whether conditions on the soil, whether it's facing the sun or not, and whether it's a mast year, all make a difference to what then happens.
So perhaps Clements describes a general process, and Gleason describes in detail what actually happens on the ground.
That randomization, yeah.